Hey guys, welcome back to another video on Lousy Gamers. So today is Friday, so I'm back with the Friday Thoughts. So before I go into my Friday Thoughts, I would like to thank every one of you for subscribing to my channel. So we have 1,000 subscribers. It's definitely a lot for me because I started with kind of nothing, and then it's all your support that now we have 1,000 subscribers, and we have like almost quite a lot of video views. So I'm really grateful for all your support, and I hope you would continuously support me with your support. And thanks a lot again. And I would also like to thank Ember for giving a shout out in one of the, their videos and then posting it on Facebook. I'm pretty sure that kind of gave me a lot of followers and subscribers. And thanks for Ember too. And I hope you're all enjoying the videos that I'm making. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe, and please hit that like as hard as you can. So again, before going into the Friday thoughts, as usual, I'm going to have beers this time around. I'm going to try the local one. So before that, I'm going to show you a local delicacy in Indonesia. So I mean, it's an Indonesian food, but probably in different parts of Indonesia they have different names. Not different names. The name is the same across Indonesia, but the flavor would be different from each region within Indonesia. So this is called sate. I'm pretty sure most of you would know who visited Indonesia. So this is actually meat that's pounded. So it's not minced. It's actually pounded, and it's also with the spices. So they'll add a lot of the chilies. Chili meaning the pepper. We call it in the North America. So the peppers, and then they'll add the coriander, all sort of turmeric, all sort of Asian spices that you would not really have in the Western food or continental food. So then what they do is basically pound, and then they make a thick paste of it, and then they would actually add that to this stick here, and then they grill it or barbecue. So either way, so that's how they make this, and this is really really delicious. And I like this version of it because the spices, you can actually feel it just bursts into your mouth. There are different types, as I said. Some they don't have a lot of spices, but they have the sauce that's been added, like soy sauce, heavy, different variations. But the point is, sate is really good to have with the beer, and usually you get this with the peanut sauce. That's pretty good with that. So you got kind of dip with, and then you eat. But now I don't need that, so I'm going to have my beer and the sate before I start my session. And you got to try this bintang. So this is the local beer. This is really good. This is really good. Okay. Now, so I'm going to have another sip. This is good. Okay, so if you remember in my last session, I said I'm going to kind of share some of the ideas that Ember can actually implement that would make our lives easy. And these are all the ideas that I kind of collected from the subscribers, from my friends, some from the other games that I play. So basically, this is all the ideas that I came up with. Some might sound stupid, and just excuse me if it's like too stupid, the idea is, I mean, again, it's coming from a lot more people. Again, it's the challenges that they face in the game might not be the same as you do. So please use this opportunity to give in your suggestions and ideas in the comment section, and hope Ember watches this video and tries to implement some of it, hopefully. So let's keep trying, right? So okay, so this is the first one, right? So hit ICs when bubbles. So this, everybody wants it, because a lot of people, they kind of perma bubble, right? So they have too much of trouble in the region, so they keep bubbled for forever, and they don't have much to do. So unless, you know, just transferring resources or even talking to people, other than that, they don't really have anything to do in the game, and hitting ICs is pretty much everybody likes to do nowadays. And And I think Ember should think about giving an opportunity for people to hit ICs when they are bubbled. Right now they can raid, that's a good thing, so at least people can raid, but hitting ICs is something that people are used to, and I think, in my opinion, hitting ICs when bubbled should be something that Ember should think about. So the second one is with mega cities, right? So mega cities are not really in reach nowadays with all bigger alliances in one region. So smaller alliances have no bloody chance to get to top 10 or top 5 for the events and to get the boosts or the mega city buffs they get. So now I think Ember should think about putting the alliance and social gaming back into perspective and try to implement something that the alliance members can contribute to a buff. For instance, you can get 10% attack bonus for infantry. So you can actually support that with gold or other resource like wood or oil or something like that. So basically what this idea is all about is get the social gaming. People get together, they spend time, they spend the resource, and they work towards getting an alliance in a better spot. So yeah, obviously the mega city buffs are pretty good. So you get the buffs, but you know, you see only a few people putting up the power and then done top 5. And a lot of these smaller alliances are giving up because of that. They can't really get into top 5, and it's really pathetic that people are losing confidence in playing this game, or lose not confidence, losing hope that they can actually get to the top 5 to get a city buff. So I'm pretty sure all the other alliance, big alliances, will also be fast enough. They'll be fast to get to the buffs. But the smaller alliances now have something in terms of social gaming to get together and keep the alliance going. And also, people might not close the alliance because, again, the gift levels plus the buffs that people have added would keep the alliance intact. So that's pretty good in my opinion. So this is an idea where people contribute for a particular buff for the alliance, not for a particular person or a team. It's for the whole alliance. They would actually add, contribute to get a certain buff. The third one, this I think everybody would love, search for tiles, right? I know I kind of understand why Ember is coming to a point where you have to go search for tiles or infected cities, you know, scouting or not scouting, you gotta kind of look into the map for a very long time until you get some where you want to get. For example, if you want to find a level 6 food, you got to keep, you know, looking on and on and on and on. I kind of get the point where you keep the player busy and engaged in the game. But I think what I personally feel is Ember should have, say, if you go to the map view, they should have a small magnifier kind of icon. You click on that and then you have options to either search for tiles or infected city. And you can actually select the level that you want to kind of hit. And then it automatically shows one of the nearest infected city or tile. Again, it doesn't have to be free either. It could be VIP enabled. To be honest, I think VIP is kind of BS. I think the more you get out of VIP, people will actually use the VIP points. I'm using it, but I don't get much. And also, I'm willing to spend a bit more gold to get more VIP, so you can make it a bit rare to get and make people spend on gold. But the idea is people should be able to search for tiles or infected cities by enabling the VIP button. So that's something that I thought would be cool to have. And open all harvested items for VIP or gold. So this is again from Ethan Walker, one of our subscribers. I did read the comment from my last video that it's really frustrating to open all the items one by one, so there is no open all for the items. So in my opinion, and Ethan Walker's idea is that we should actually have open all the harvested items or the resource in one button, so that you don't really have to click every time. So that's, again, it could be part of VIP or it could be part of extra gold. So I'm not asking for free, or we're not asking for free. You can actually link that to VIP or something that people can spend gold on. So that's number four. Number five, attack and defense quick button. So this is pretty much in all the games right now. So what this actually allows is you can actually set up three different attack and defense combinations. So when I say combination, it could be the troops that you send or the leaders that you actually slot in. So basically what this means is you can actually have say setup one for three stalkers and a dead row for infected attack. So number two would be with for vehicle attack, or number three with all three. So, and you can actually reset with gold or whatever is the store items that you can actually make them purchase. So the idea is you can actually set up these quick buttons where you select and then you assign certain type of troops and leaders to it for attack, and for defense you can actually set up the leaders. So you don't really have to freeze and unfreeze, and you know, it helps a lot, and especially when the when there is a war and then you need to have change quickly, I think this would be the best option.
Yeah, so you kind of get the point, right? So it's about searching for, I mean, it's for having three different combinations, quick buttons to activate what you like. So this saves a lot of time and also get people to spend more gold. So that's the whole point. So number six is, is a quick change for hero skills. So again, I know hero skills are too hard to set up. So again, three different combinations that you can have for attack or defense or gathering, what could be, you know, whatever it is for people to set up. So the idea here is to have three different setups, and you can actually set up what kind of skill points that you want to assign for different things. Like before you go to bed, you want to change to defense, and then when the war time comes, you click on the attack, and for harvest events you have the gathering, something like that. So again, you can actually have this as instead of 750 for hero reset, Ember can actually say 2000 gold for setting up using the quick buy. So again, you know, you can spend more gold, but the idea is to make our lives a bit easy. So the next one is filling the tiles. So I'm pretty sure everybody kind of likes this. So this is about filling the tile instead of say manual selection. So you don't know if you want to fill a 1.6 million worth of tile with resource, and then you keep changing or sliding. It's painful. I think this one should be a default where you click on a tile and say and gather all or something like that. So that kind of helps people to send all the troops at once, and they don't have to do a manual check all the time. And I think this is something that we wanted for years and years now. So next one is extra building or research from for selection with gold. I mean, it's like you spend about say 10,000 gold and you get one extra building for 24 hours, or you can do an extra research for 24 hours. Again, you can actually you cannot do any research more than 24 hours with that. So if you want extra building or research to be done, so say if it's 1 week, then you got to buy for like, you know, 50,000 for a week or something like that. So you can actually spend gold and get extra research or extra building to have that extra. I use too much of extra, so you get that point, right? So it's more like having two tasks done at the same time. So you know, you can build two buildings and do two research at the same time. So and the next one is territory-based special farms that belongs to Alliance. So when I say territory-based, you have the map now. So people are going with hives, and I think this is, again, it might change the game a bit. So the idea here is you get people to plant your Alliance. It could be some pillars or something like that, so that you mark your territory, and then within that territory you can actually, the leaders or whoever has that, you know, lieutenant or major or somebody who can build some special farms. So basically the special farms are does have like I don't know, 100, 200 million worth of resource at once. So you can actually send up to 10 people to gather from there. So again, when people are gathering, the enemies can attack and all those kind of things. So it kind of spices up the game, in my opinion. And also, people can spend gold or resource to build special farms within the territory. And if the enemy chooses to expand their territory, this farm will actually be part of theirs. So it starts a territory war, and it makes things interesting, in my opinion. So the special farms might be something that Ember can think about.
Okay, so the next one is the wars in the virtual world. So people can actually participate in war when they are bubbled. So what happens is within inter-region, or it could be within region, you can actually declare war against another alliance. And then these are some of the things that's already in some other games, but I think with all the setup that we already have in Empire Z, I'm pretty sure this would be a much better option. So coming back to the point, so the wars in the virtual world is like, you know, so you create a space where people port in, and there'll be like two big cities where each city will have room for people to port in. So in one alliance, you can have like 10 or 15 different people, or 100, even 100 people are active, then everybody sends their troops in. But then these two fight against each other. So the more troops they kill after a specific time, so the war can be about 20, 25. So whoever kills the troops first will win, or whoever, once the timer is finished, whoever kills the most troops wins. In during that period, you can allow people to use heal speed ups, regular speed ups, so that again people can spend their speed ups, all they get from the infected cities, to heal the troops, and then keep sending the troops back again and again. So it's like just imagine there are like 10, 15 active people who are participating in the war, and then the opponent have like 20, and each of them sends about a maximum of 5 million troops or 6 million troops. And then each sends the troops, and then they fight. And then if the troops die or injured, so they actually have to bring more troops, and then, or they have to heal the troops with the speed up. So that's the point. And obviously when they go back to their original region, the troops are not dead, basically. So these are the virtual troops as well. So whatever they bring in, they fight and then they go back. So, but the point here is Ember can actually get people to spend gold or for healing, or the speed ups that they have, too much of speed ups that they have to spend. I think the people would actually like this, because again, a lot of people who are perma-bubbled or too small to even fight and lose their troops can get a taste of how a fight looks like. So that's something that I would like to share. So the next one is Scout Shield. So this is something, you know, like a fog or something. It's most likely like, it's not about hitting. So it doesn't allow you to scout or recon a city. So that's pretty cool, right? I mean, you are a big player and you don't want to let other people see what you have. So usually people can send one troop attack, but you know, this is something that I thought would be cool to have, like put a fog on it and then let people not see what you have in terms of in terms of resource. So one troop kind of tells you what they have in terms of troops and leaders and wall defenses, but the resource, no. So this could be something that you can put a fog on like forever, and people can't scout. And it's going to be really interesting as well. So number 10 is, not number 10, I think I got the numbers wrong. So the next one is, this is in most games. I don't know whether this is legal anymore, but it's all about gifting gold packs and also speed up to other people. So you can actually gift to another player. Basically, if you have the alliance name, and maybe within alliance would be a starting point to give speed ups and also gold, or you can actually buy packs for others. So this will allow the smaller players, right, to grow more. I think these smaller players, I think they don't have speed ups, and then the bigger players have too many, And the problem is, what happens, Ember, is that because of the gap, and the smaller players are quitting, and then if you can get these players to experience and spend the speed ups and then come up to speed with, not to the levels where the bigger players are, but at least to catch up with them, so these players would start to spend and they start to be active. So right now you're making it like really, really hard for people to spend money. I mean, they don't want to spend money before. A lot of people want the proof of concept, so they need to get hooked, and they need to see how they can actually get the game a bit different with all these speed ups. So the point here is, if Ember can allow to send gifts in terms of gold packs and speed ups, that would be good, and it could also be a revenue stream for you, Ember. So if you think about it. So the next one is sending resource to ally. So if you have set your alliance to friendly, you should actually see if you can actually allow the resource can be transferred from your alliance to your friendly alliance. So I don't know if it's a good idea, but I thought maybe since it's an ally, I think it should allow people to contribute to each other, and even I would say open up the chat for alliance and the allies. I don't know, you know, all the allies can be in one chat and then they can do the chat. I know, because the user interface is kind of set up now, so it's really hard to change the user interface with all these changes, but I'll leave the job to the experts there in Ember. If you guys think these ideas are good, and please think about it. So the next one is the last login information for leaders to manage inactive. So we don't really know when a player was last engaged, and I think this is really important for keeping an alliance going. I know you haven't been in an alliance or been a leader, Ember, so please, you know, you don't know how much important this information is for the leaders to manage the alliance, and this would be like really the players would welcome if you kind of do this. So just try to get the last login information so that also, you can actually reward players for most active time in terms of hours or days in the game. So I don't know how the algorithm you want to set up. It's like active, or it could be some actions that they want to do, and then you can track those time. So basically, at the end of the week, you can give them some gold or some goodies to keep them engaged. So the next one is deleting the messages. I know you, even this would actually save your server space. You should let us delete some of the reports and also the personal messages and your, you know, other messages from Ember that you're sending. So it kind of gets too much, and I think for me, I would like to delete it immediately once I'm read, and I would like to keep only a few things that I wanted to read or refer in the future. And I think having a delete button, so just check all, delete, would be really, really fantastic, so that it would save space on your end, and it will also be a good feature for us to delete unwanted messages. The last one, actually, yeah, we are coming to an end. Mission based events. So I think now the events are good, but I think other than that, we should have mission-based events. It's like, when I say mission, say you should have like 20 different missions for all the alliances. And then each of the alliances should be able to, progress from level 1 to, say, level 20. So the level 1 would be hit 25 level 1 ICs. And then you progress to level 2. So hit level 15 to 20. 100 ICs, and then you keep progressing, and then you could actually mix everything. Like, you should have a war points of 5 million, or you could actually say that total infected cities hit should be 50,000. So people would then start to play these mission based for the whole alliance, and whenever the mission is completed, they will get the goodies. And then obviously you can actually reset, or you could actually travel to another new set of missions after the 20 missions are complete, something on those lines. So so these are some of the ideas that I got from everyone, and hope you kind of like this, and obviously I might have missed some of the best ideas that you guys might have. I don't have this in paper, but you have an option to put your ideas into the comment section and hope we get all these, not all, at least some of it gets implemented. Ember, if you're watching this video, please, please try to get some of these implemented so that the players get engaged more. So, without any further delay, I think I've taken a lot of time from you guys, and thanks for watching, and have a great weekend. I know in most of the countries it'll be a long weekend for Easter, and happy Easter, and I'll speak to you all next week. And also, I promise I'll be doing some of the training videos like I used to do before. With all the travel and other things, I got kind of busy, so I'll try to do more in the coming weeks. So all enjoy your long weekend, and I'll speak to you later. Thank you.